Well, hello everyone. I thought I'd take this opportunity to put together a little video with an update on how things are going at Cheltenham Elam Church and to let you know a few things that are in store for the months ahead. We've actually now been in Cheltenham officially for 6 months, six whole months, which is hard to believe. And it's actually gone really fast. But it's for us as a family, it's been a really positive experience. And I can honestly say that I really loved to begin to get to know everyone. And I think I know most people's names now, which is great. We've also done a surprising number of things in quite a short amount of time. I've loved our regather evenings, our vision and value meetings have also been a really great time together. And I've also really enjoyed getting together on a Friday with the seniors. And a real treat was the fish and chip supper that we enjoyed a while back. It's also been really great getting to know everyone working at the church and volunteering at the food bank. And everyone is really working hard to serve God, to serve the community, and in particular to help people that, for many of them, are in a time of real challenge. And it's humbling to see how people serve every Sunday, over and over, behind the scenes often. And thank you to each one of you that is involved in that. We're obviously now entering the Christmas season, and I'm looking forward to our gathering on Sunday with our Bring and Share lunch. After that, we've got our Christmas nativity on the 18th, and I'm sure that's going to be a great morning. I know that the kids and the kids workers have been working really hard to get together their little nativity production, so that's one definitely not to miss. We'll also be getting together on Christmas morning at 10 a.m, which falls on Sunday this year, and we'll also be meeting at the normal time on New Year's Day. Looking ahead into January, in our small groups leading up to Easter, we're going to be exploring the Gospel of Luke, and it means that by the time we get to Easter, we'll be thinking about the resurrection narratives at the end of the Gospel. And if you aren't in a small group yet, I really encourage you to sign up for one. It's a great way of deepening relationships with others in the church and feeling part of the church. I'm also going to be leading a couple of pizza and Bible evenings like we've done before. And a few people have been asking me about the second coming of Christ, so I thought I could do a session on that. And I thought that would be fun. We're also going to be hosting some of our worship evenings in the new year. We've been calling these regather up to this point, but from January we're going to be calling them refresh. And it's really going to be a great opportunity for us to get together, to seek God together, to pray for each other, and to see God's Spirit move. So there's lots to look forward to in the new year, and there's lots of other stuff happening as well, which I haven't got time to mention. So that's my little update. Let me finish with a thought from the book of Acts. Immediately after the day of Pentecost, we read in Acts 3 that Peter heals a man who was unable to walk from birth. And he used to beg at the gate called Beautiful, you know the story. And the healing causes this great commotion and prompts this impromptu sermon from Peter, who famously says to the onlookers, "Repent then, turn to God, that your sins may be wiped out, that times of refreshing may come from the Lord." And although Peter's words are addressed to non-believers, they also tell us something really important about God. They tell us that he is someone who loves to bring times of refreshment. And in context, these words are filled with significance. Pentecost has arrived, and it's that Pentecost celebration came at the end of a very long, dry spell of weather, and as the desert winds had been blowing up from the south for a long time, 50 days in fact. And on the day of Pentecost, that's the day the wind changed, that's the day the rain came, and it still happens today. And of course God uses this timing to speak to us about a spiritual refreshing that would end a spiritual dryness, the coming of the Holy Spirit. So I'm no prophet, and yet I get this sense that the church, after struggling through COVID with all the restrictions and challenges that brought, after our time of regathering, I really think the church is stepping into a new season, and that God has in store for us times of refreshing. And as we head towards this new year, I believe it's going to be a significant one in which we're going to see God's Spirit move afresh. And my current encouragement to us as a church is that we are expectant, we position ourselves into that posture of readiness that I've been talking about, just like those early disciples in the upper room, spending time together, searching the scriptures together, praying together, and getting ready for the wind and the rain of the Spirit. God bless you. Thanks for taking time to listen, and see you really soon.